Welcome, everybody, to a brand new series, and it's a game I've actually wanted to do for a very long time on my channel, and that is the original Contra for the NES. And you'll notice I am actually inputting the Konami code here, so I am going to be starting with 30 lives. And that is because I do not think I can beat this game without doing that. Now, my goals for this series is to not die too often. I want to beat the game without having to continue, so that I get a one total score at the end. And as I said, I don't think, and I'm gonna not use the bridges here because of the death trap that comes after it there with all those soldiers. And hopefully I can get that. Dang it, I missed it. That power-up was the spread shot, of course, the most infamous weapon in this game. Also the best weapon in this game. So I hope to get that quite often. But I've been meaning to play this game for quite a while, and as I said, I want to beat it on just one continue, which is why I'm using the infamous Konami code, which is, as of course I'm sure all of you are aware, up, up, down, down, left, right, BA, and then start to start the game. Now we have the spread shot, so let's see if we can get the R to also increase the rate of fire for it. But yeah, I've wanted to play this game for a while, and kind of my original plans for the game was to use the PC version. There actually is a officially licensed PC kind of compilation or collection that includes the NES versions of Contra and Super C or Super Contra. And I'm going to kill this guy up here, jump over his bullet, and then just use the spread shot to destroy the first level boss here. But it also includes not only those two games, but also the essentially the NES versions of the Castlevania games as well. So Castlevania 1, 2, and 3. And my plan was to use that to record Contra, but I was unable to kind of figure out a way to record that reliably in a quality that I was happy with using my computer. So ultimately what I decided to do was just buy a version of the cartridge for the NES, and I'm actually recording this on my NES. Although it's not an actual NES, it is an emulator, so to speak. It is a clone console called the AVS, which is put out by Retro USB. It is a fantastic system. It works with pretty much every NES cartridge, and it outputs an HDMI. It's a little expensive. It's kind of a higher quality item, but I love it, and I enjoy it quite a bit for playing these NES games. And because I do have quite a few cartridges I wanted to play, that's why I ended up going with that system, because I want to be able to play other games in my NES collection, games such as DuckTales and Darkwing Duck and Batman the Video Game and the like. So you can expect those games at some point, but we are already to, as I die, the level 2 boss here. Not too difficult, you just have to avoid these little bullets that it shoots out. And then once you destroy all four of these little platforms that are kind of flashing at you, then the real boss shows up. And they do kind of recycle this boss, although with a new twist, for the second kind of base level, which will be coming up in level 4. So, you know, my goals for this are, again, as I've mentioned now quite a few times, beat the game without having to continue, and then I hope to kind of challenge all of you who are watching this to beat my score, whatever it ends up being. Now, if the 30 lives is too much, if that's not enough of a challenge for you, you certainly can just play the game regularly where you get the 3 lives per continue, but I am not confident enough in my Contra skills to be able to do that. In fact, I've only beaten this game one time even just using the regular 30 lives. And because of the point system, you actually can get extra lives, so I end up actually getting like 33-ish lives once I get all of my points kind of totaled up for everything. So we'll see what happens, how many of those I actually end up using. Can I beat it in under 30? That'll kind of depend on how many I have once I finish the game. And ultimately, that'll determine whether I did it in the original 30 lives or not. Now, I like the F shot here, the fire shot or whatever it is. I don't know what the actual F stands for. because of the kind of spread of it. Now, the spread shot, of course, is the best. It's the most powerful, and it has the best range, but I like the massive range. It's basically the size of your entire character, so it works really well at taking things out pretty fast. But we are speeding along here. Contra is not a series I played a ton of. I played the original and beaten it a couple of times. But I have not played any of the sequels, so I haven't played Super Contra, Contra 3 on the SNES, or Contra 4, which I'm not sure what system that's on, like the DS or something like that. But I do want to play them all, and I actually am planning on doing that. I'll probably get the other versions through Virtual Console, because that's a little bit easier to record, and cheaper. This cartridge... Contra is not really released on like Virtual Console or anything like that. You can only really get it, you know, basically through the cartridge or, of course, an emulator if you're into that sort of thing. So I had to buy a cartridge, and they're kind of rare. They're not super rare, but I had to pay about $30 for it. We are now to the Stage 3 boss, which is this massive kind of lizard or alien type creature. Not really a lizard, more of an alien. With these arms, and I do enjoy watching speedruns of this game, so I have a general sense of kind of what I'm supposed to do with the bosses. So you don't have to kill the arms. Basically, if you do that, as that arm is pointing at me menacingly, it makes the alien open its mouth quicker, and the way you kill it is to shoot the alien in the mouth while avoiding, as it again points at me. Ow! Dang it. But shoot it in the mouth while it opens it, and you have to hit it like, I don't know, 20, 30 times, depending again on your bullet, what weapon you have, and that determines how quickly you can kill it. But we're not doing so bad. Now, usually when I play this game, I'm already down to about 20 lives at this point. That third level, for the most part, tends to be pretty brutal for me, so the fact that I got... Okay, I'm dying unnecessarily here. But the fact that I got through it so quickly and relatively well, make sure to utilize the duck here. Ducking is a really good mechanic for these base levels because most of the bullets will not hit you. Now they do eventually adjust and will start shooting lower. And of course they send those little rolling barrel things at you, but you can destroy those with your bullets. Now the difference with this base versus the other one is it's a little bit longer. You have slightly more enemies, and they start incorporating these other platforms, like these flashing displays here that you have to kind of break through in order to get to the big orbs, the weakness spots that you can hit for critical damage. And there is sort of invincibility frames for the most part for a lot of these structures you have to destroy. So you do have to wait, even though sometimes it's there initially, like when you first get into the room. But this kind of always reminded me, like I never played this game originally when I owned my NES. So I played games like, for example, Friday the 13th on the NES before this. So when I first saw this game, I was like, oh, this is sort of like when you run through the cabins in Friday the 13th. But obviously this game is, you know, leagues and leagues ahead of Friday the 13th. That is a terrible, terrible game. Maybe someday I'll play that game. I don't actually own the cartridge anymore. So that would be part of a series that I'm considering, which is kind of a revenge series where I go back and play games from my youth that I wasn't able to beat when I was a kid and kind of try to beat them today. But I think we are almost to the boss of the fourth stage here as I die yet again. So we gotta take out this orb and then maybe in the next room the boss is? Yeah. So similar again to the stage 2 boss, you have these little platforms you have to destroy, but this time now we have soldiers kind of coming out in addition to the bullets that are being shot. Then we have guys with wings jumping at you, angel wannabes. And then we have two of these heads we have to kill while they also shoot little orbs at you that will somewhat track you. And if you watch this game actually in 30 frames per second, you'll notice that basically what's happening with these heads is that all they're doing to get this kind of effect of the splitting is they're just alternating the frame back and forth quickly to make it look like there's multiple heads. It's actually pretty cool. But we're almost done here. So next time, I'm going to finish up with the last four levels of Contra. We'll finish it off, and hopefully I will be able to do so without having to continue. We'll see if that's possible or not. But as always, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this series, and I'll see y'all next time as we continue onward with the game.